హలో హలో ఇప్పుడు వస్తున్నాను చూడండి, చెక్ చేయండి, ఇప్పుడు వస్తున్నట్టుంది. హలో హలో, దేంట్లో పెట్టారు?
హెడ్ఫోన్స్.
ఇంచు కరెక్ట్ జాక్లో చూస్తున్నారు. ఉంచండి, ఆడియో ఉంచండి, ఒకసారి స్పీకర్ ఉంచండి. ఓకే, ప్రొసీడ్ అవుతామండి. ఇప్పుడు
A very good morning to one and all. And today we have a session on a very important topic, that is satellites, small satellites, because recently India has procured Rafale fighters to combat.
హలో ఎవ్రీబడి, ఐఎమ్ వెరీ సారీ దట్ ఐ మేడ్ యూ టు వెయిట్ ఫర్ లింక్. న్యూ లింక్ హ్యాస్ టు బి షేర్డ్. ప్లీజ్ షేర్ దట్ లింక్ టు ఆల్ ద మెంబర్స్ అని అక్కడ షేర్ చేయండి. ఎవరు చేస్తున్నారు? ఖర్చు ఏం చెప్తారు? యూట్యూబ్ చాట్లో హలో ఎవ్రీబడి, I'm sorry for the delay. Whatever happened as of now, it's almost 1 hour I took your time.
YouTube chat.
sir, with the permission. I tried to just play one more video, but sorry, it got failed.
Delay, whatever happened as of now, it's almost 1 hour I took your time.
Okay, speaker button, Chandu. I can speak. But, hello, I hope it is live now only. Can I proceed? Can I start?
Just wait a second, sir. I need to share the link.
Yes, yes.
Just 2 minutes, sir.
Yeah, sure, sure. ఇది ఫాలో అవ్వండి పైన హలో ఎవ్రీబడి ఐఎమ్ వెరీ వెరీ సారీ పర్టికులర్లీ రిలేటెడ్ టు ద డిలే వాట్ ఎవర్ హ్యాపెండ్ యాజ్ ఆఫ్ నౌ this is because of some unknown problem, in fact because of audio or video or system malware errors, because of which it took this much of time in proceeding further. So myself, Dr. Sharad Kumar, I'm professor of electronics and communication engineering, KL University. Dr. Balaji sir is very well known to me for last 15 years. He is currently with MRIIT, based on his interaction, and so currently I am delivering this content with you all. Actually, I tried to play one video, introductory video, especially before to start of this presentation, but because of this error and delays and also arrangement of that particular video, not possible now. Therefore, I am proceeding further. So this is the outline of my presentation. Related to the small satellites. Hope many of you are from either electronics or speaker. So many of you are aware of major basic electronics and basic computer coding and so on and so forth. this presentation, whatever I am trying to deal with you, is exclusive of small satellites, which is usually not available in any of the textbook content. So I am trying to give you a total overview of how small satellites are all going to be from various countries, especially from the student community, how the students will come forward for related to the small satellites. So, and I just wanted to share everything with you in this presentation. So the small satellites, the introduction, pros and cons, various types of small satellites, followed with statistics and market growth, how it is all going to be in current scenario, focus on CubeSats, development process overview, and role of satellites, especially in terms of ICT and related applications. So even though basic satellite communications and related content, which is available for you in general in relation to the various textbooks, but I am not at all bothering and dealing anything about that in this presentation. So what are all considered to be the small satellites, and how does this small satellites is all going to consider to be in size aspect? So especially if you see, small satellites or CubeSats or nano satellites or pico satellites, these are all segregation based on the weight, the size of a particular satellite. So in this presentation, I'm trying to give you the overall scenario of how a small satellite is all going to be in general, and later on the segregation and so on and so forth I'll be dealing with. So if you see the picture, whatever that you are seeing in this particular slide, a smallest chip or satellite, which is in the fingertips of a particular person, named Robert Manchester in specific, can be seen. The size of that satellite is all going to be of 4 grams, and weight of the satellite is all going to be of 4 grams, and size is considered to be 3.5 centimeters. So then you can understand how small it is, and it is also considered to be a small satellite used for launch vehicle for the purpose of studying the satellite related application aspects. So I'm going to deliver some information related to the small satellites based on this segregation, whatever I'm proceeding now. So we all know very well that majority of the satellites which are launched by ISRO geostationary orbit satellites used for the purpose of country-wide communications or global communications. So those particular satellites are all considered to be at 36,000 kilometers. Whereas in this presentation, I am dealing with small satellites as a title, but majority of the content that I am going to deal is CubeSat or related satellites. So my presentation, even though it is segregated into 5-6 tables, the one whatever I am trying to go and deal is all considered to be less than 100 kgs of satellites. So you can see the various satellites which are on screen, maybe geostationary 1360 kgs, two of MTOSAT satellite which is of 0.1 kg. So in between we have NanoSat 10 kg, PicoSat 1 kg, and other satellites which are of various sizes and so. So the segregation, which is based on the weight of a satellite, is listed in the second table: large, mini, micro, nano, pico, and femto. So 100 grams lesser, the satellite which is considered to be lesser than 100 grams is said to be femto satellite. The one whatever we have seen in this slide, the smallest one is considered to be a femto satellite. So the same one, the small typical classification of small satellites, which is presented here, a nano, pico, femto, again that is our concentration now. And in this one, the lifetime of that particular satellite is also provided. So earlier we have seen the weight and mass. Now based on the particular satellite, how it is expected the lifetime, or if that is, once the satellite is launched into the space, how extent it is all going to be there. is the one that we need to look into. So some satellites may be having lifetime of only 1 week, 15 days or 1 month or so and so forth, whereas some of the satellites are based on the design, solar power system and so on and so forth, it may work till 2 to 3 years also. Whereas geostationary orbits, usually they design for 7 to 10 years, but majority of the satellites even now, even these days, are working which are of 10 plus years. So the cost per kg is also listed here in this slide. So you can see some more pictures in this satellite, in this slide, where in which the femto, pico, cubesat and so on and so forth. So what is a cubesat? So the name itself indicates like it is a cube like structure consisting of 3 by 3 by 3 centimeter in area, whose weight is up to of 1.3 kgs, and we can have combination of such kind of cubes up to 24 in number. Like stacking that particular cubes up to 6 and making that into 4, which we can have 24 cubes together, we can make particular satellites. The relevant references of it we can see in the below links, whatever I listed. So the picosat, which is of 200 grams, having an antenna which is in the arm of a particular person, picosat 2 is a reference taken from the particular slide. You can see the size of the satellite. We have a point and idea of it requires a huge electronics and so on and so forth, whereas in reality, for a particular scientific application, a small sensor also considered to be a small satellite useful for the activity. So this is what we need to understand related to the small satellites and CubeSat. So how these satellites and what purpose the all these satellites are going to be launched? What is the reason for it? What are all the various options available for us? So it may be for the purpose of scientific research, technology, Earth observations, military applications, educational purposes, telecommunications, astronomy, and so on and so forth. So few of the satellites which are launched here in 2013 has taken as a reference the PhoneSat, SwampSat, ArduSat, SensorSat, and BrightPL, and so on and so forth. That the references are taken from the link which is presented below. So the dimensions, as I told you, something like CubeSat is considered to be in the form of cube, where we have a provision of stacking such kind of cubes together in that means, so that total of 24 units can be stacked together. And the typical models, which are 6 stack, can be seen in the right hand side picture, and the CAD models of that particular cubes, how they are all going to be, can be seen in the below picture. So what is the purpose of going for the small satellites? So the point of observation that we always wanted to just share is launching a geostationary orbit satellite whose weight is more than 3000 kgs or so, the cost is up to 10, the cost is up to 1000 plus crores. And also the success of the geostationary orbit satellite these days by Indian Space Research Organization is considered to be significantly good. Whereas the miniaturization, which is leading the world in terms of just having less size of electronic components, subsystems, which are all making the particular materials which are all available in the market, are making the system to be smallest as possible, so that the idea of small satellites came into the picture. So similarly, these days if you see the consumer electronics like television, mobile phones, commercial off the shelf related modules, industrial grade electronic components are all considered to be coming with less size, shape and as well as weight. So therefore, using such kind of components for the similar applications, whatever that we usually use to go for bigger satellites for Earth observation systems, why not we use such satellites in such satellite components is the one that we need to look into. Therefore, the small satellites came into the picture. So advantages, in the sense where we have a provision of just proceeding with reference to we have a provision of proceeding with reference to advantages in specific related to low cost, short time scientific results. Whenever we just wanted to just work out for some kind of results and outcome, definitely we can make use of these small satellites as a mode. For example, recent China war situation, the symptoms of it, whatever that we are seeing, obviously such instances to cover that hilly regions, we are in need of a small satellite. So therefore, small satellite. Therefore, launching a satellite of that purpose, which is going to work only for few days or so to support the military systems, then we need such kind of small satellites. And relatively less development period also can be observed, especially for these small satellites. So international cooperation is also can be seen much with the small satellites, and ideal for small scientific payloads. Multiple satellites can also be launched in one go. Like ISRO launched 104 satellites in one go, that is considered to be the record in current scenario. So the disadvantages of these small satellites can also be looked into. So especially if you see these small satellites, as and when they are launched much in number, then they may cause a space debris. Similarly, lesser lifetime. If it is a geostationary or meostationary orbit satellites whose lifetime I told you about 7 to 10 years, whereas these small satellites which are having lesser lifetime of 2 to 3 years, lesser than that, even few hours for some of the satellites, and launch slots and more waiting time for small satellites, because a launch vehicle has to be made available for majority of the satellites to go in one case. So limited function, especially due to size and size aspect. So if you see the specific screen over here, these are all the various space agencies which are existing in the country India, useful for the purpose of launching India and as well as abroad, useful for the purpose of space activities in their respective countries. So out of which I took significant space agencies like CNES, European Space Agency, NASA, ISRO, JAXA, and UK Space, and so on and so forth, are considered to be most significant. DLR, German, is also one important space players who are working significantly good in the market and helping the small satellites and also launching various satellites in the market. So if we see the statistics and market growth, how it is all going to be, especially for these small satellites. Even though the small satellites which are in existence for few years before, but the importance of it which it came into the existence only in the recent years. The reason being, the experimentation is done, good number of satellites have been launched by the agency, reason which majority of the satellites, whatever they are in successful stage for small scientific related operations, therefore small satellites came into the existence especially from 2013 onwards. So if you see the statistics, 2019-20, in fact leaving the 20 activity, till 19, there is an average growth of up to 400 to 500 satellites which are launched by the various agencies in the world. So the same number of satellites, how the growth is observed till 2010 and how the growth is going to be from 2010 to 2024, next 15 years, is listed over here. The point, you can see, are on average more about 10 to 15 satellites which are launched per year, and whereas if you see post 2014, on an average 200 plus satellites have been launched for the purpose of either science exploration, telecom, earth observation, and technology related purposes. So expected launch of more about 3600 small satellites by the SpaceX. You might have seen recent NASA also sent people to the moon, sent people to the space, International Space Station, ISS, so that it is now coming out with an option of bulk sending of satellites to the space, and having collaboration with various country space agencies in the world. SpaceX. So the satellite market, how it is all going to be growing. So earlier we have seen the how, what are the numbers per year. Later on the theme and as well as year, how they are going to be. Now if you see, there is a significant growth of 37% for last 10 years till 2019, whereas it is expected to be more than 24% in next 6 years. Keeping in view of this corona situation, there may be slight variation in the percentages also. Where about 400 nano satellites which are expected to be launched into 2020, which got postponed into 2021. So the launch vehicles, if we just wanted to launch a satellite, definitely we are in need of launch vehicles, and these launch vehicles are considered to be the one which are carrying these small satellites to the space. And these launch vehicles, the major supplier or major service provider for these launch vehicles is from NASA, that is from United States of America. So what, who are all the other players in space industry, especially related to the small satellites or cube satellites used for various applications? So Satrect, Initiative, GeoOptics, Clyde Space, SpaceX, Nova Nono, Planet Labs, NovaWorks, Planet IQ, Orbit Earth are all are considered to be significant players, especially for related to these small satellites. So this sector is particularly now globalized sector and international sector, having the satellites which are launched and available all through the space, all through the covering all through the globe. So there are four colors which are listed here, especially academic, government, industry, and as well as non-profit, and the blue indicates academic satellites which are launched by various universities, colleges, and students like you. And red indicates the government satellites, green indicates the industry related purposes, and violet indicates not-for-profit satellites which are launched across the globe. So here if you see a satellite up above the sky, it is a very important and interesting thing. I just wanted to share with you all. You can try these links. I'll also try to share and post these links with you in YouTube, so that clicking that link you can even understand and know that how many number of satellites which are up above on your sky. Like if you are residing in Hyderabad, how many number of satellites which are available and crossing the region Hyderabad today and now. Similarly, the option of which satellites which are going to cover the region Hyderabad, hopefully by today evening 4 o'clock, tomorrow morning 6 o'clock, and so on so forth. Likewise, you can understand and know about the movement of satellites lively covering your region, and you can even having certain you can even track those particular satellites having the relevant satellite equipment with license. There is a provision for us. So all the satellites whatever they are crossing us, maybe of application oriented satellites, scientific exploration satellates, or geostationary, other geostationary satellites used for the purpose of telecom related activities. So these links, n2yo.com or n2yo.jp, Japanese website, which is considered to be the important one in the scenario in the market. So coming to the case of components of small satellites or CubeSat, if you see, there are only 9 to 10 significant components or parts, especially for the small satellites. So the most important one, it is similar to the communication system, whatever you have studied in your whatever you are studying in your engineering. So a receiver, a transmitter, an amplifier. In simple, these three are considered to be communication system blocks. Receiver, transmitter, and as well as amplifier and antenna. Similarly here also, an antenna, amplifier, the specific sensors which are used for the purpose of scientific exploration, onboard computers for processing the systems, it may be microcontroller or microprocessors compatible to the system, the magnetometers, and the total system is all considered to be covering with aluminium panel and subframes, and gallium arsenide solar cells and UHF antennas, and so on and so forth. So any satellite that whatever you're talking about usually consisting of these modules, whereas the BSP instrument is the one which is considered to be the variable parameter, where based on your scientific application you can have that instrument. It may be of a mobile phone, it may be of a sensor camera, it may be of biological related and material testing sensors, and so on and so forth, can be replaced with that module. So the small satellite, CubeSat, focus areas are all considered to be 70% conducting for the purpose of technology demonstrations. Especially there are applications in the current scenario which was happened in the world, how mobile phone works in the space, sending alone the mobile phone and studying that mobile phone in space, sending some sensors which are used to test the biological particles existing in space, sending some sensors or X-ray based sensors, how X-ray will work in space, and many applications like that. So these are all considered to be technology demonstrations which are fulfilled by various parts of the world by universities and scientific organizations, and so on and so forth. And 50% are conducting for the purpose of scientific research. So the scientific research is to study the oceans, hilly regions, or earth observations, or taking the pictures of various earth objects or other planets, and so on and so forth, are considered to be scientific research. And 50% especially supporting the education purpose, where students like you can also be a part and parcel of a small satellite from your institution if you have an idea of launching a satellite. So that is also possible with good number of scientific organizations, based on the significant idea whatever been generated by you, they are supporting the cause. So biological, earth, near objects, earth orbital debris, astronomy, space weather, and for the purpose of technology demonstration, how space power is all going to be, radiation testing, and solar cells is all considered to be the focus areas of small satellites. So CubeSat launch initiatives. So CLSI, the CubeSat launch initiative from NASA, is the most important and popular in the world, not only in other countries, in India also this is popular, where we can submit our idea to them. If idea is good, then they will support us in all aspects. Similarly, from ISRO also there are a good number of space launch initiatives are there, but waiting time is considered to be significantly little high. So these CubeSats, the purposes of it, we already discussed, to have deep space navigation and operational systems and payloads, which it consists of various things like trajectories, thermal modules, and so on and so forth. So benefits to the educational organizations and non-profit organizations, especially related to this CubeSat launch or satellite, small satellite launch, is which it enables the ideas of teachers, students, and faculty work together to develop the hardware modules. As you know that Make in India is the one which is coming, leading now in the country, India especially, dealing with supporting of local systems for local activities and scientific research, technology demonstrations, and so on and so forth. Likewise, if you are in a position to come out with an idea of a small satellite and developing that relevant hardware, definitely you are going to have a lot of knowledge acquired in that area, and also which it will helps in development of technologies, especially for the purpose of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Enhanced education experience can be achieved while working with certain kind of hardware modules. It's not only the small satellites I'm talking about, it is the overall scenario, how it is all going to be helpful for us as a part of the small satellites in reality. So benefits to the space agencies, so develops innovative and public-private partnerships, and which it will get some kind of ideas from the students as a part of low-cost technology development, as a part of low-cost development, they will explore the scientific reality of that ideas. So as of now, we had a discussion about various satellites, how the launch process is all going to be, and what all the various scenarios that we are in situation to understand about the CubeSats, and how what are all the combinations that we can work out, especially related to the CubeSats and CubeSats and scientific explorations, CubeSat weight, mass, and so on and so forth are all covered as of now. So if you see the next part of the presentation, which is all going to give you the overall development process overview. So if you wanted to launch a satellite, what is that you are in requirement to start with, and how much time it is very much required for you, what are the various procedures to be fulfilled especially for launch of these satellites, and all can be understood from this particular slide onwards. So there are various phases existing over here, especially related to the small satellites: the concept development, secured funding, securing the funding, feasibility reviews, the total design of a system, responding to the CLSI call, mission coordination, licensing, hardware testing and fabrication, mission reviews and dispenser technologies, and launch of the satellite. So these are all the various systems and mechanisms that we have with us. We are in requirement to follow them for the purpose of understanding the design technology overview process. So let us take 1 minute for the let us take just a minute. Questions are not slide. Okay. So let us just proceed, especially related to this small satellite launch initiative, a technology development process existing in it. So if you see, if you have an idea to develop that particular idea, to initiate that particular idea, it usually takes 1 to 6 months. So if you have an idea that alone does not suits to us, definitely we have to have some kind of funding for the launch of a small satellite or CubeSat. So the CubeSat launch usually, which it costs about 3 to 4 crores, sometimes based on the number of satellites which are going in one go, the cost can be reduced up to 1 crore. So once the idea is available and done with us, definitely we have to have the feasibility review, like how the feasibility, in the sense, if I wanted to make the total salt water existing in the ocean to the sweet, it's not possible, in fact. So the only option that is available for me is desalination, but I can also do it only for limited quantity of water. Whereas, therefore, before to proceed further any of the idea related to the cube satellite, definitely there is a requirement of proceeding further related to the feasibility study. Definitely that is very much required. So that feasibility study is whether it is possible or not. When once that is done, the CubeSat designed to be fulfilled for which is going to happen for 6 months. So we need to wait for the space agency call. When once that particular space agency is accepting applications, we need to submit our application to the space agency. Then the space agency will see the pros and cons of that particular proposal, and they will estimate the budget of it, and they will come out with the decision whether they are accepting that or not. When once that is done, the design is done, the selection is happened from the side of space agency, then it has to be scheduled for the mission coordination, and this is the actual step where in which the small module usually be taken into the laboratory setup, and they do the thermal testing, vibration testing, and various other types of testing to understand the system, how it sustains across the various tests. So Mission Mangalyaan movie, if you see the module, whatever that you have seen, that it has gone to the extent of various tests in one of the song in that particular movie. That is called the mission coordination module. So licensing. So licensing is the one which is covering especially the frequency aspects. Like if you wanted to communicate with the ground station, or if you wanted to have some communication with the inter-satellites, definitely the frequency is to be allocated so that in that particular frequency only the satellite can be traced or tracked accordingly. So therefore, this particular licensing is the one which is going to be given by the Federal Communication Commission, FCC, for all the countries in the world, so that the frequency of operation can be considered accordingly. So the flight demonstration and the ground testing, CubeSat hardware fabrication testing, all these things usually will go accordingly. And finally, the 13th step is CubeSat to dispenser integration and testing, and launch is all going to be on one day. So evaluation of a small satellite project. So if you see, the evaluation is all going to be mission objectives, mission requirements, launch vehicle, spacecraft requirements, ground segment and subsystem requirements. So amongst all the mission requirements is the most important one, where it consists of payloads, the actual purpose of the satellite used either for scientific exploration or technology demonstration or any other purpose. So once that is done, the most important thing is in which orbit the satellite has to be launched, and the power that is very much required for the purpose of satellite, and the ground stations, those are used for the purpose to connect to the satellite, and subsystem requirements, which it includes communications, attitude controls, thermal, power and structure base. So how the system at satellite attitude, in the sense how it is behaving in various scenarios, how the power is coming from the solar panels, how the communication is happening from telemetry down ground station to the satellite and vice versa case, all these things are covered in the subsystem requirements. So the spacecraft block diagram, as I told you earlier, that it consists of various small components like thermal sensors, mission payloads, antennas and so on and so forth. Similarly, the subsystems, whatever they are there usually in a small satellite or CubeSat, which are all listed in this. So the sun sensors, analog to digital converters, onboard computers, onboard data storage, solar array, battery, interface, infrared spectrometers, electro spray thrusters, radiators, heaters and so on and so forth. Each module is having its own importance of either providing the power to the system, or making the system to communicate with the ground station, or to make the system to communicate within itself, or to provide information from space station or satellite to the ground station, or to transfer the data existing from satellite to the ground station in the form of data or images or so on so forth. All of them are happening in one module, which are totally at far away distance from the ground station. Whereas the antenna is the one which is playing an important role, especially for communication from satellite to the ground station. So, if you see the space station payload and as well as the drivers, which are all existing, this is little extent advancement of the submodules existing in that ADCS, RF system, power system, thermal control system, telemetry and telecommand. Out of which TTC is the one which is making an important role, having communication from ground to satellite and satellite to ground. So RF system, which it will take care of making the data transfer and so on so forth. So spacecraft as a particular system, if you see, the spacecraft itself as a system, the bus structure and payload are considered to be important modules. So the payload module, which is the one which is connected in the spacecraft, and the bus structure, which is useful to have intercommunication between various modules existing in the small satellite or CubeSat. So similarly, whatever you have studied in your microprocessor, microcontrollers, where we have data for data transfer, information communication peripheral interface, microcontroller, if it is considered to be, which it consists of all components, microprocessor and other things are also considered to be a part and parcel of microcontroller, which is used only for the specific application. Likewise, this spacecraft, which it consists of this payload module and bus structure, used for the purpose of connecting the thermal, solar, payload, other subsystems, propulsion subsystem and communication and data handling, which are all happening only in one module. So spacecraft electrical systems, which are all considered to be digital systems, RF systems, which it consists of transmitter, receiver and attitude and orbit control, AOCS modules, and onboard computer processing systems and power cells. So power cells are considered to be solar cells and battery and electronics related modules. So as of now, we discussed altogether about satellites, weight, mass and so on and so forth, various satellites which are launched across various years, the components of a small satellite, followed with an idea of various subsystems or spacecraft existing in small satellites or cube satellites. At the same time, CubeSat and its launch technology, launch procedures, design procedures, whom to approach and what to do. Now, from this particular slide onwards, I am going to concentrate especially related to the role of information communication technology in space sector and especially the small satellites. So ICT is just nothing but information communication technologies, where majority of the students I understand are from electronics background and computer science background, wherein which having a part and parcel of this particular satellite in view of ICT, where broadcasting, telecommunications and internet technologies. So day to day, if you see, the technology advancements are happening and changing significantly, where with the mobile phone, where we are in a position to have all communications which are possible effectively. So similarly, there are some possibilities. 5G technologies are going to come, especially in the scenario where 5G is totally different one, where all the data, whatever the that is available, which is going to be made available in the nearest server, so that we can achieve large data also in shortest possible time. That is the benefit of 5G. So ICT specific means the communication part of the small satellites, nano and pico satellites. Usually the frequencies which are going to be operated are considered to be of uplink and downlink, which is of 144 to 146 megahertz, and downlink, which is of frequency specified there, 144, 146, 435, 438, 2.4K, 2.45K and other frequencies. Similarly, for scientific space research related activities, the frequencies of 400.15 to 401 megahertz and 2025 to 2110 megahertz frequencies. And these frequencies, which are all totally coordinated by space frequency coordination group SFCG of FCC and as well as United Nations ICT wing. So the role of ICT in small satellites, which is all discussed in the part of first two slides or so, in the means of miniaturization of technologies. These days we have system on chip, which is all available, considered to be various modules on are available in single chip. So at the same time, multiple chip modules, which are useful for the purpose of having the thermal reliability, compact size and so on and so forth, reason which these are all going into the idea of small satellites, so that the size can be reduced to the better extent as possible. and chip scale packaging, all these are considered to be the VLSA based technologies or nanotechnology based studies, where chip scale packaging, which is all considered to be major number of components which are mined together in one package, in one chip, so that whatever the application that is in requirement for us, then directly we can make use of it with the for the purpose. Similarly, MEMS, microelectromechanical systems, which are providing good number of sensors for the purpose of scientific exploration and studies. And miniature optics. In optics also, we have smart cameras, mobile phone cameras. These days, if you see 100 megapixel cameras also coming out from Samsung and other significant players in the market. And without having especially the camera with us, we can shoot anything of our choice. That is all possible in lesser sizes because of this miniaturized optics. So the things whatever I told you, system on chip or PCB, from PCB to system on chip, how they are all going to be integrated and so in one go. So spacecraft as a subsystem where power, digital systems, AOCS, thermal control structure, onboard computers, launch vehicle, TTC and RF. Of which ICT part is all going to be of onboard computer, TTC and RF systems are a part and parcel of information communication technology where majority of you are interested usually. That is all going to be helpful for you in the major scenario of designing a small satellite concepts. So systems engineering is the one which is considered to be interdisciplinary approach, where a person having a knowledge of full modules, it may be of thermal, it may be of power, it may be of bus system, it may be of payload, it may be of aluminium panels that we are using and antennas used in a small satellite or cube satellites. Having a person having a knowledge of all of them is considered to be of a systems engineer, and the corresponding study of all, integrating all these disciplines is all going to be of systems engineering concept. A systems engineer may have many roles, as I told you, interface control, validation, verification engineering, vendor interface, technical manager, information manager, process engineer, and so on and so forth to be worked out. So role of system engineer is considered to be payload, conducting a series of payload interface meetings, especially with a team of people, whoever is involved in the design of a small satellite, and making availability of control document consisting of electrical, mechanical and ground segment aspects. Similarly, he has to have the idea of power that is used by the small module, especially so that how long the system is going to work with power and what is the backup suitable to that, and all of them are considered to be a part of the systems engineering or systems engineer, role of system engineer. And this onboard computer, which is going to work overall, especially with the telemetry system, telecommand system, thermal sensors and so on and so forth, used for the purpose of connecting the payloads to the system, so that as and when there is a requirement to work, to make the system to be autonomous or autonomy, to work on their own when system gets failed, then this OBC is the one which is going to be helpful to look into that kind of activity along with the regular activity that is supposed to do a part of integrating all the system modules existing. So these are all some of the real-time pictorial representations, especially how this fabrication is all going to go in terms of various aspects. These are all little old photos, whereas the bottom one, which is all going to be of new one. So starting with PCB wiring, coating a material with various chemicals for the purpose of ensuring the activity to be achieved, and completing the module of wiring and assembling all of them in one CubeSat and sending it for the testing. These are all part and parcel of electronic fabrication aspects. So coming to the case of telemetry data transmitter, tele RF systems, especially coming to the case of RF systems, telemetry data transmitter, tele command receivers, payload data transmitters, and GPS receivers. So this TTC is the one which is all going to be a significant system used to communicate from satellite module to the ground station. So whose operating frequency is of 435 megahertz, and VHF which it will works at 145 megahertz, and so on so forth. So telemetry telecommand receiver block diagram, which is listed here, this is usually available in the textbook content also, therefore I am not putting much concentration on it. Whereas the typical system, the satellite to the ground antenna, from the satellite, after filtering, it goes to the low noise amplifier, which it amplifies the signal whatever that has been received, and across the down converter, the frequency is down converted into the other frequency wherein which our systems are in a position to recognize that, and across over which the local oscillator is attached to that, so that other frequencies also can be combined to that to make the signal to be transmitted to the other location or larger distances. Finally, a baseband system. So baseband system is nothing but a system which it consists of all frequencies close to the zero. So telemetry data transmitter, which it consists of carrier generator, modulator, power amplifier, filter, to the satellite and as well as to the ground antenna. So here also across modulator from the baseband, whatever the signal that is coming out, which is combined over here, across. It is all the source of all these telemetry data transmitter is all payload telemetry. So typical specifications of TTC systems. So the frequencies of operation are 145 megahertz and 435 megahertz for TM and TC modules, whose data rate is up to 1 kilobytes per second, and antennas which are used mostly are considered to be of monopole based antennas. So a payload data transmitter, which is all considered to be VHF, S band, X band, KV band, and so on so forth. As and when the band of frequencies which are operating band of frequencies are enhanced, then the speed of data transmission can be achieved to the greater extent. Likewise, these days Ka band transmitters are used in the satellite modules, where in which we can achieve 320 megabytes per second data transfer from space station or satellite module to the ground station in terms of various scientific exploration studies. So onboard GPS receiver is also the one which is useful for the purpose to track the satellite, where it consists of L1, L2 frequencies, which are corrected frequencies of ionospheric layer, and it receives four GPS signals from the four GPS satellites, and which it automatically computes on its own the ranges and location and share it with the ground station. So digital systems are telecommand systems, telemetry system, and so on so forth, used for the purpose of transmission, reception, and so on so forth. So AOCS is the most important one, which it helps us in having the behavior of a system, whether the system is in a position to sustain at higher frequencies, at higher temperatures, higher altitude, and the nearby systems, whatever they are objecting some electromagnetic induction or electromagnetic interference, electromagnetic compatibility standards, and everything can be looked after by this AOCS module. So major elements of AOCS are considered to be of to measure the satellite attitude in terms of its GPS location, height, and other parameters, and so on so forth. So this attitude control and determination system, which is going to provide some information about the spacecraft behavior especially. So it consists of some algorithms, so that based on those algorithms, automatically if something went wrong in relation to the behavior of the system, it tries on itself to rectify the system to work accordingly. So if you see, this is a typical small satellite module system which is controlled by the ground station. The ground station, which it consists of a setup where it is in a position to receive the signals, further followed with the idea of pre-amplification, whatever it is happening from the antenna, and post-amplification processing is done, and whatever the signal that is received at the ground station, it is processed and is absorbed accordingly with the system available with us. So the typical model which is usually used even for the Mars, recently Earth launch of satellite which got failed, this is a typical system used over there. So if you just wanted to have some set softwares useful for the purpose of satellite launch or otherwise small satellites and cube satellites, then you can see and you can make use of these links for the purpose. So Java Astrodynamics Toolkit, open source CCMA software, ny2o.japanese-based website and relevant softwares, OpenFlight Linux and related softwares, which are all available, considered to be the open source tools for which are useful either for the algorithms or which are useful either to control some of the systems existing in a small satellite or CubeSat modules. And NASA also, which is providing some open source software can be used for the purpose of these small satellite launches or cube satellite modules. So typically, as of now, if you see, satellite related idea is understood, design processes are discussed, various subsystems across the small satellites are covered, followed with role of information communication technology, especially related to the RF systems, ICT in terms of telemetry, telecommand, onboard computers, and so on and so forth were discussed. So now, if you wanted to have a module to be made available from your institute, definitely this is the one you have to have accordingly. So the project director, system engineers, where they can look into the procurement component modules, payloads, and as well as launch vehicle. All of them are in a position to have some kind of collaboration and coordination with the system engineer. In turn, he will respond to the project director. Below to them, we have project managers for structure, mission, thermal, digital related hardware, and RF systems, AOCS, onboard computer, and power mechanisms. So each project manager is responsible for their own module, and all of them usually be integrated with the payload into the one single system, so that the outcome is significantly achieved in a form of one module. So how this configuration management and control can be achieved, especially in view of various trade-off aspects to be taken into the consideration. So the project managers, whoever is dealing with mechanical, thermal, and related payload modules, have to have interface with have to have interface together, and they need to check all the systems working alone and as well as when combined together, followed with finally they need to come out with an idea of whole system into one typical module. So configuration control, where do changes comes from? So whenever there is a change in the design process, it has to be informed to the project manager, who in turn informed to the project systems engineer. Then only the overall system variation, because changing one system during the process of design, which is having some compatibility issues with other modules, definitely a care has to be taken, especially related to the other modules also. Therefore, this is very much important. One has to always remember, one has to always to be remembered further. So, interface definition and control. Interface is all considered to be various modules connecting together. For example, I am having a camera or I am having a USB mouse. If I don't have the USB port in my system, then there is no point of having this USB, wireless USB. So, therefore, definitely I have to have the compatibility of various modules together to be connected into one interface so that the final system gets ready. So, interface systems may be of mechanical systems, data format, electrical systems, thermal systems, and external interfaces, which it may be of spacecraft, launcher, vehicles, and so on, so forth. So, the other things, whatever they are there in this, can be seen over here. Testing and evaluation, when once the total systems are integrated, we are in requirement to study that various, we are in requirement to perform various tests, vibration, thermal test, environmental test, equipment, sustainability test, and so on and so forth. So, lifetime testing also usually be performed in the space environment. For example, the space environment is going to be created in the ground station so that this particular module is going to be launched and it can be studied across. So, what are all required, especially related to the realization of these small satellites or CubeSats? Team of experts, engineers, technicians, fabrication and assembly related testing facilities, which in terms of mechanical, thermal, and so on and so forth. So, one point I would like to see, we don't need to have all of these modules with us if you just wanted to launch the small satellite or CubeSat. We have to have only the mission, a point like payload, which payload that we wanted to launch, which we wanted to concentrate, is the one that is very much important and useful. Rest is all where we have various service providers available in the market. We can take their support for testing purposes and fabrication purposes. So, mechanical fabrication facilities related to the CubeSat and small satellites consisting of CNC machines, ultra precision machining facility, electricity discharge facility, and diamond turning machines, CMM machines, roundness tester related modules, submodules, various chambers like cold chambers and hot chambers to create such certain temperatures as in need to test the system performance, especially across various temperatures when it is in the space. A similar environment is all going to be conducted here. So, vibration testing facilities, they are all going to be of useful for while launch of this particular small satellite module in the launch vehicle. While it is going into the space, there are a lot of vibrations or a lot of disturbances usually be caused to the system. So, studying that system and understanding that idea of that particular vibration, how it is all going to be happen, a similar facility or setup is going to be managed in the ground station also. So, thermal vapor or vacuum related facilities. So, space consists of vacuum, there is no gases which are existing in space, especially how these are all going to, how the small satellite is all going to work at that, in that scenario can be seen using thermovac facility. So, areas of expertise which it requires for the purpose of the small satellite are vibration modules, VHDL modules, software coding of algorithms, mission operations, systems engineering, coordination with the space agency in the country like India, it is ISRO, and mechanical systems are fabrication, vibration, thermal, and finite element modeling and structural design, and so on so forth, are part and parcel of this launch of design of small satellites, where all these expertise are very much required for us. So if you see this particular slide, consisting of various satellites which are launched by the students, especially in the country India. So NMIT, MSRIT, MS Ramaiah College, BMS College of Engineering, Chaitanya Bharati, CBIT, Vignan IT College, and so on and so forth are part and parcel of the small satellites which are launched by the students, either in the individual means or otherwise in a group form, group consortium, and so on and so forth. Similarly, Anna University launched ANUSAT satellite, which is used for the purpose of amateur radio technology and demonstration purposes. So Pune University launched infrared cameras into the space, and SRM University launched remote sensing cameras. IIT Bombay fulfilled the launch of satellite used for the purpose of total electronic content in Earth's ionosphere. Similarly, the PES College remote sensing camera. So the power system consisting of solar array, battery, and power electronics. So therefore the idea of the solar array. So the idea of power system, solar array, battery, power electronics, and so on and so forth is all going to be a part and parcel of power system. Power overall block diagram is all going to be a power source, a battery, DC to DC conversion, storage devices, and load. Because power is playing a most important role, especially for the whole systems, whole subsystems in a small satellite module to work. So therefore, without which there is no point and observation, especially related to the small satellite. So therefore, an important criteria and steps to be fulfilled, especially related to these small satellites in terms of power. Some important information, textbook content like continuous power, peak power, duty cycle, power budgeting, power storage, and so on and so forth are discussed in this slide. So sometimes the solar arrays, whatever they are used in the small satellites, or which are of this size also for geostationary orbit. So solar cells, chemical batteries, which are used for the purpose of supporting the power, supporting power during launch phases, provide power during eclipse, and provide power during demands and loss of log. So these chemical batteries, which are part and parcel of these small satellites, also useful for the purpose during solar eclipse, because the solar cells, whatever they are there in the small systems, which are run by the use of sun energy. Whereas during eclipse, there is no point of sun energy. Therefore, we need to have the alternate of either existing storage or otherwise the chemical batteries of such nature, which are in a position to help us to be always in contact with the ground station. When once the power of the system goes off, then the whole system goes off, and the link to the ground station will be off. So comparison of battery performance. So if it is a lithium ion battery, if it is a nickel hydrogen or nickel cadmium batteries, how they are all going to be, which are presented here. So battery sizing. So power budget examples, especially related to the various subsystems existing in the small satellites. Telecommand, telemetry, payload, and so on and so forth. Power electronic related modules. And so on and so forth. So as of now, the idea of various satellites and launch aspects which are discussed related to the small satellites, the various subcomponents, small satellites and their launching procedures, which are all discussed in this presentation. So now I wanted to have some questions from the students, especially related to these CubeSats and small satellites, and I'll try to respond for them accordingly. So one of the questions from the student, is it possible for us to prepare such small satellites? Yes. If you see the slide, if you see this particular slide, these are all the satellites which are launched by the students of various colleges and universities. For example, the remote sensing camera, which is a student satellite, SatSat, on which the CBIT, RV College of Engineering Bangalore, BMS College Bangalore, MSRIT Bangalore, Vignan IT and Science Bangalore, Hyderabad, are all part and parcel of this student satellite. So if you have a real idea with you, you can submit your idea to the space agency so that your idea goes to the agency. If they like it, then they will ask for the full proposal. Then you can have your team established accordingly based on the presentation, inputs, whatever provided, so that your small satellite, which is going to come into the design or testing aspect based on their inputs. So it is quite possible for the students to be a part of various small satellite modules, which are considered to be various launch initiatives of various space agencies' launch initiatives. So do we have any chances of joining space studies? Yes. So you being an ICT, electronics and communication engineering, civil, mechanical, computer science background, sciences background, physics background, you can be a part of these space studies. So various points, whatever I listed, it is a part of electrical, civil, mechanical, communication engineer, nanotechnology based engineers, are all part of one small satellite or CubeSat. So therefore, based on your current idea, current study and idea, you can proceed, especially related to the higher studies in the case of space technology. So these are all some of the inputs I wanted to share, especially related to the small satellite. Hope this is useful for you all in understanding the concepts of small satellites. So I'll try to respond for your questions if you have any, based on the email, whatever I'm providing here as a part of the small satellite. And I thank the organizers of MRIET, Principal MR Institute of Engineering and Technology, and Dr. Balaji Garu, Professor and Head Electronics and Communication Engineering, and the coordinator for this event, the Professor Vishnu, and other students, and so on and so forth. I thank every one of you for joining and being a part of this activity and following this small satellites related presentation. I am available at my email ID kksarat@gmail.com. You can send any questions if you are not in a position to communicate now. And once again, mentioning the particular point, like the delay in starting this webinar, I just wanted to thank everyone of you for being a part of this event and activity. Thank you once again.
one for the question.